Class 11th Mathematics CBSE. Today we are starting a new chapter, that is permutation and combination. And in permutation and combination, the main topic or main role is of the factorial. Okay, so before knowing the permutation and combination, the meaning of permutation and combination, and how to find permutation and combination, we have to know about the factorial. Or what can I say, factorial plays an important role in finding the permutation and combination. Now what does mean by the factorial? Factorial is the continued product of the natural number up to n. Means factorial n is the continued product of the natural number from 1 to n. Suppose that we are finding the factorial 8. We are finding the factorial 8 means factorial 8 is equals to 8 into 7 into 6 into up to 1, or from 1 to 8. Continued product of the natural number from 1 to 8, that is factorial 8. Okay, means factorial 8 is equals to 1 into 2 into 3 into 4 into 5 into 6 into 7 into 8. Or this can be write down as 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Okay, so factorial 8. In this way we can find the factorial of other numbers also. Like we are finding the factorial 5. Factorial 5 is equals to 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1, or 1 into 2 into 3 into 4 into 5. So this is factorial 5. Okay, and we can also generalize this result up to n natural numbers, that is factorial of the n. This sign or this symbol of exclamation is the symbol of factorial. Okay, factorial. Or one more symbol of factorial is here, that is right angle type symbol. This symbol is also the symbol of factorial. Okay, both are symbols of factorial. And if we put this symbol in right side, then we read this as 5 factorial. 5 factorial or 8 factorial. 8 factorial. Okay, so factorial n can be write down as 1 into 2 into 3 into 4 up to n natural number, n minus 1 into n natural number. Or this can also be write down as n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 into, and so on, multiply 4 multiply 3 multiply 2 multiply 1. Okay, so this is the definition, or this is how we can find the value of factorial of a given number. Okay, now the main and the most important thing is that we can find the factorial of only whole number. Okay, means we can find the factorial of greater than 0 or equal to 0 also. Means we can find the factorial of 0, 1, 2, 3 up to n. Okay, means we can find the factorial of only whole number. Second important thing is that we cannot find the factorial of any fractional number. Okay, means we are unable to find the factorial of 2 by 3, 3 by 5, etc. Okay, factorial can be obtained of only whole number, that is 0 factorial, 1 factorial, 2 factorial, 3 factorial. Okay, so what is the value of 0 factorial? Value of 0 factorial and other values can be find out as factorial 1. 1 factorial is equals to 1. 2 factorial is equals to 1 into 2. 1 into 2 or 2 into 1, that is 2. Factorial 3 is equals to 3 into 2 into 1 equals to 6. In this way we can find the factorial. Now what is the value of 0 factorial? What is the value of 0 factorial? So 0 factorial can be find using the formula n factorial equals to n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 into n minus 3 and so on, 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Okay. Now we have already find that 8 factorial equals to 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. So what is 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1? This can be write down as factorial 7. So 8 factorial can be write down as 8 into 7 factorial. Okay. Again, this can be write down as 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. This can be write down as 6 factorial. So this can also be write down as 8 into 7 into 6 factorial. Similarly, can be write down as 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 factorial. Okay. So factorial can be expanded. Factorial can be expanded as we want. Okay. Means till the number that we want. Okay. So factorial can be expanded only in one terms, in two terms, up to three terms, up to four terms. Okay. So factorial n can also be expanded up to two terms, three terms, up to n terms. Okay. So what is the factorial n? This is factorial n, and this can be write down as, this can be write down as n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 into n minus 3 and so on, 4 into 3 into 2 into 1, that is equals to n into n minus 1. So factorial n can also be expanded up to two terms, up to three terms, up to three terms, that is n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 factorial, up to four terms, that is n into n minus 1 into n minus 3, n minus 2 into n minus 3 factorial. Okay. So factorial can be expanded up to one term, two term, three term, up to n terms that we want. Okay. Now we are finding the 0 factorial. We are finding the 0 factorial. So 0 factorial can be find out by using the formula, using the factorial n is equals to n into n minus 1 factorial. Okay. We know that factorial n equals to n into n minus 1 factorial. Okay. So put n equals to 1 both the sides. So 1 factorial equals to 1 into 1 minus 1 factorial. Means 1 factorial, that is 1, 1 equals to 1 into 1, 1 into 1 minus 1, that is 0 factorial. So 0 factorial is equals to 1. 0 factorial equals to 1 and 1 factorial is also equals to 1. So both are having the same value, 0 factorial as well as factorial 1. Okay. So in this way we can find the value of 0 factorial. Now we cannot find the main next important thing is we cannot find the factorial of negative integers. Okay. Negative integers means we cannot find the factorial of minus 1, factorial of minus 2, factorial of minus 3. These are not possible to find. Means we can find the factorial of only non-negative integers. Means 0, 1, 2, 3 up to positive infinity. Okay. We can find the factorial. Okay. Now the next thing is, now finding the value of n factorial plus n plus 1 factorial, that is equals to n factorial plus n plus 1 factorial can be write down as n plus 1 into n factorial. Okay. This can be expanded in one term, up to one term, that is n plus 1 into n factorial. So n factorial can be taken as common. N factorial can be taken as common. This is 1 plus n plus 1, so equals to n plus 2 into into n factorial. So n factorial plus n plus 1 factorial is equals to n plus 2 into n factorial. Okay, so this is the explanation of n factorial plus n plus 1 factorial, means how to find the value of this. Now the next thing is, that is n factorial upon n minus r factorial is equals to n minus r factorial is equals to n factorial can be extended n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 and so on, n minus r plus 1 and n minus r factorial upon n minus r factorial. Okay, means n factorial can be expanded up to n minus r factorial like this. Now n minus r factorial will cancel n minus r factorial, so this is equals to n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 into and so on n minus r plus 1. Okay, so value of n factorial upon n minus r factorial can be found out using this way. Now if n plus 1 factorial equals to 12 times of the n minus 1 factorial, this is just like an example. If n plus 1 factorial equals to 12 times of the n minus 1 factorial, then what is the value of n? Okay, so we can find the value of n by expanding the factorial. But which factorial should be expanded? Only the factorial with greater number should be expanded, means this factorial should be expanded up to n minus 1 factorial. So n plus 1 n factorial equals to 12 into n minus 1 factorial. Again this can be expanded n plus 1 into n minus 1 factorial equals to 12 into n minus 1 factorial. Okay, now this will cancel this. N minus 1 factorial will cancel n minus 1 factorial. So n into n plus 1 equals to 12. Means n into n plus 1 equals to 3 into 4. Means n equals to 3. So value of n equals to 3. Okay, this is all about the factorial. Now we will solve the questions of the exercise 7.1 related to the factorial. Okay, so let us have the exercise 7.1. Exercise 7.1. Question number 1. So we are solving the questions of the exercise 7.2, and this exercise is related to the factorial. Okay, so question number 1, first part of the first, that is finding the or evaluate factorial 8. So factorial 8, that is equals to 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. So this is equals to 8 5 ja 2 3 ja 6 6 4 ja 20 4 24 5 ja 120 120 6 ja 720 720 into 56 8 into 7. Okay, so this is equals to 7 into 8 2 ja 16 40200. Okay, so factorial 8 equal to 40200. 8 2 16 1 5 7 6 0, then 7 0 42. 3 3 5 4 0 3 2 0. Okay, factorial 8 equals to 40320. Now finding the value of factorial 4 minus factorial 3. So next question is second part of the first, that is factorial 4 minus factorial 3 is it equals to. Factorial 4 can be write down as 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 minus 3 factorial can be write down as 3 into 2 into 1. So 4 minus 1, taking 3 into 2 into 1 as common. So 3 into 3 into 2, that is 3 3 is 9 to 18. So factorial 4 minus factorial 3 equals to 18. This was question number first, second part of the question number first. Now taking the second question, that is factorial question number second. This is factorial 3 plus factorial 4 equals to factorial 7. Means does the left hand side is equals to right hand side. Okay, so left hand side is equals to 3 factorial plus 4 factorial is equals to 3 into 2 into 1 plus 4 factorial, that is 4 into 3 into 2 into 1, and this is equals to 3 to the 6 plus 4 3 is 12, 12 to the 24. So 24 plus 6, that is 30. Okay, so factorial 3 plus factorial 4 equals to 30. Now factorial 7 is equals to, factorial 7 is equals to, factorial 7 is equals to 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 equals to 2 3 is 6, 4 is 24 5 is 120 into 6 7 20 7 20 into 7. So this is equals to 70 7 2 14 1 7 7 14 9 1 50 5 0 4 0. So factorial 5, factorial 7 is equals to 5 0 4 0, and factorial 3 plus factorial 4 equals to 30. Okay, so factorial 3 plus factorial 4 is not equals to factorial 7. Okay, so addition of factorial 3 plus factorial 4 is not equals to factorial 7. Now we will solve the question number 3. We have to solve the question number 3 of the exercise 7.2. Question number 3rd is factorial 8 upon 6 factorial into 2 factorial, that is 8 into 7 into 6 factorial. Factorial 8 can be expanded up to 6 factorial, that is 8 factorial, 8 into 7 into 6 factorial upon factorial 6 into 2 factorial. 6 factorial can be, so 56 upon 2 factorial, that is 2 into 1, 56 upon 2 equals to 28. Okay, so factorial 8 upon factorial 6 into factorial 2 is equals to 28. Okay, now let us have the question number 4. This was question number 3rd of the exercise 7.2. Now question number 4. Question number 4 is, if 1 upon factorial 6 plus 1 upon factorial 7 is equals to x upon factorial 8, then find the value of x. Okay, very important question in respect of examination point of view. Okay, so 1 upon factorial 6 plus 1 upon factorial 7 equals to x upon factorial 8. Okay, the greatest is 8 factorial, then 7 factorial, then 6 factorial. So 8 factorial will be expanded up to 6 factorial, and 7 factorial will also be expanded up to 6 factorial. Okay, so 1 upon 6 factorial plus 1 upon 7 factorial can be 7 factorial will be expanded up to 7 into 6 factorial equals to x upon 8 into 7 into 6 factorial. So this is equals to 1 upon 6 factorial, 1 plus 1 upon 7 is equals to x upon 8 into 7 into 6 factorial. 6 factorial will cancel
6 factorial on both the sides.
So this is equals to 7 plus 1 upon 7 is equals to x upon 8 into 7.
Okay, so solving this,
we will have 8 upon 7 is equals to x upon 8 into 7. 7 will cancel 7, so x is equals to 8 multiply 8, so x is equals to 64.
Okay, this is question number. Next question is, evaluate factorial n upon n minus r factorial when values of n are given. So question number,
next question is, evaluate factorial n upon n minus r factorial if, this is first part, if n equals to 6 and r is equals to 2. Okay,
so put the value of n and r
in the given expression, that is n factorial upon n minus r factorial. So n factorial, that is 6 factorial upon 6 minus 2 factorial, 6 factorial upon 4 factorial. Okay,
now
expanding 6 factorial up to 4 factorial. So this can be write down as 6 into 5 into 4 factorial upon 4 factorial. 4 factorial will cancel 4 factorial, 6, 5 are 30. Okay, so 30 is the
answer of the given expression.
This was first part, and in second part it is given that n equals to 9 and r equals to 5. So put the value of n and r in the given expression. It is 9 factorial upon 9 minus 5 factorial equals to 9 factorial upon 4 factorial equals to 9 into. Now 9 factorial will expanded up to 4 factorial.
9 factorial will be expanded up to
4 factorial. So this is equals to 9 into 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 factorial divided by 4 factorial. So 4 factorial will cancel 4 factorial, and this is equals to 9 into 7 into 6, 5 is 30 into 8. So this is equals to 9 into 7 into 3, 8 is 24, 240 equals to 9 into 7 multiplied to 40, 0, 7, 4 is 28, 2, 7, 2 is 14 and 2, 16. 1680 multiplied by 9 is equals to 0, 9 and 72, 2, 7. 9, 6 are 54, 54 and 7, 61, 6, 9, 1 is 9 and 6, 15, 15, 1, 20. Okay, so value of this 9 factorial upon 9 minus 5 factorial equals to 15,120.
Okay, this was the last question of the exercise 7.2. Okay.